can send you a link.
Yeah, yeah.
Of course you're my favorite sponsor. Yeah, we're glad to have you as part of the show. Okay, thanks, Mom. All right, bye. Gotta keep the sponsors happy.
Yeah.
Where's Jeremy at? It's about time to start, isn't it?
All right, let's get started.
What did he eat?
Welcome to the PB&J Show.
With Pastor Bradley.
And Jeremy.
Where we talk about things that matter.
And a lot that doesn't. What's up? And welcome to episode 4 of the PB&J Show. We're glad you're tuned in. Hey, a couple of things that you may not know. Number one, we always do our show in one take. Every single episode, one take. The second thing you may not know is that we are now featured on a podcast.
Nice.
So if you don't have time to watch, you can listen to the PB&J Show. It's on Apple Podcasts. It's on Spotify and all other kind of platforms too. So check it out. Listen to it. Give us a like, subscribe, all that good stuff. We're thankful for our listeners and people that tune in day after day.
Definitely. In German, four is wir. Wir.
You're so educated.
I try. I have Google, so that helps. That helps a lot. That's a good-looking water you got there.
Thank you.
We've got a lot to talk about on our show today, starting with we're going to do a game.
Yeah, people have been asking for a game.
They've been requesting games, and so we're going to talk about called a FaceTime Challenge game. Mm-hmm. Jenny, who's one of our executive producers here on the PB&J Show, come on in, Jenny. I can't help but say Jenna. I don't know why. Jenna. So explain the rules of the game, Jenna.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a category for someone to call via FaceTime, and whoever gets someone to answer first will get a point. So the first person you're going to call is a church member. 1, 2, 3, go. They're both looking through. Oh, Jeremy's making a call. He's found someone. See if they answer.
Oh, man.
Bradley's still scrolling.
I'm trying to find a person I can call. Who could I call?
This is intense, guys. Jeremy's is still ringing. Online. Bradley is still scrolling.
I'm struggling here.
Okay, Jeremy's giving up and moving on to find another contact. Jeremy, you're not allowed to call me.
Oh, dang it. What if I get a hold?
Okay, I'm trying Colton Stroud. Come on, Colton.
Bradley's making a call.
Come on, Colton.
Jeremy's thinking of who to call.
Come on, Colton. Answer. Colton.
Colton, if you can hear me. Colton Stroud, answer. Here it goes.
Okay,
it's ringing.
Jeremy's making another call. This is intense. Whoever picks up first. Come on.
She's technically a Macedonian member, so I get the point.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
It's not
okay.
Come on.
Colton didn't.
Incorrectly.
Oh, come on.
They're still both trying to figure out who to call.
Church member.
That'd be bad if I got the point. All right, come on. Church member.
This is intense. They're both scrolling through their contacts.
Oh, okay. This counts.
Okay. All right, Jeremy's making a call. Bradley's still scrolling. Jeremy's is still ringing. Oh, it's connecting.
Oh.
Jeremy gets the point.
Hey. If they are on there.
You don't have to talk to me long. We were doing a game to see who would answer our FaceTime call. And I'll
man.
Win. All right. So Jeremy has 1 point.
Thank you for answering.
Mm.
All right, love you.
Man.
Bye.
All right.
Vicky.
My mother-in-law.
How does that count?
Because she's a church member.
Wow. Okay.
So Jeremy kind
my
of cheated,
loves me,
but he still gets the point.
Vicky Harris.
All right, are you guys ready for the second category?
Yeah.
Call a member of your family that is not your wife.
Yeah, I got you.
I'm going to call her again.
Calling Nana. You can't call her. I'm calling Nana.
Jeremy,
come on, Nana.
You cannot call the same person.
Come on, Nana. Come on, Nana.
All right,
Nana's going to answer.
Making a call.
Come on, Nana. Here
okay,
we go.
They're both calling.
Come on, Nana.
Waiting to see
come on,
who
Nana.
Answer
the phone,
first.
Nana.
Oh,
Jeremy got the point.
Hey, sorry, we're playing a game. I had to FaceTime a family member that would answer. So.
Nana's not answering.
I won.
Oh, no.
I love you.
I love you.
My cousin Megan answered.
Awesome.
There we go.
All right.
Stupid game.
So Jeremy has 2 points. Bradley is still at 0.
This next one's worth 20 points.
It's not an Apple product. That's why.
Oh, no.
It's also transparent. All right.
Okay. So, number 3. Mm-hmm. Call a student from your ministry. 1, 2, 3, go.
Man.
They're both scrolling through. Oh, Jeremy's calling. Bradley is still scrolling. Bradley's making.
Oh! That doesn't count. He's in the next room. That does not count. Hang up. Hang up.
Jeremy.
Hang up. That doesn't count. That doesn't count. He's aware of the game.
I'm not sure.
Okay.
Jeremy's going to call again because Tyler's in the building.
Cheater. Come on.
All right. Bradley's still calling.
This ain't going to work.
I'm sweating. This is intense. All right. Come on.
All right, Jeremy's calling another student.
All right, I'm aborting that mission. Let's try new.
All right, Jeremy got an answer.
For sake.
Hey, we're doing a FaceTime.
All right.
Man.
So Jeremy called Nick.
Oh.
Ministry, and I chose you, son.
Nick.
Hey,
Nick. Nick's on the show. Welcome, Nick.
Welcome, Nick.
I'm glad I got to see Nick today.
BB&J show.
Hey, Nick. Let me say hey to Nick. Hey, Nick. Good to see you.
All right.
He's a good kid. I'm not bitter about that.
All right. Well, technically Bradley is lost, but we're going to do one more round.
This is worth 4 million points. Okay.
Winner takes all.
Winner takes all. Yes.
All right. Call someone that you know has watched the show twice.
Oh, that'd be my mama.
All right.
Come on, mama. She's at work. She's a nurse. Shout out to all the nurses out there. Come on.
Jeremy's also making a call.
Come on, mama. Who you calling? Matt Queen. Not Matt Queen. Mama. Mama called.
Bradley
called. Mama called. Yeah,
right,
mama, you're on the PB&J show. Congratulations.
Matt Queen, you made me lose.
My mother's a nurse. We want to shout out all the nurses during this difficult COVID time. Thank you, mama, for being a nurse. I'm glad you're on. She's got a mask on, people.
There we go.
Good.
That's awesome.
Love you, mama.
All right.
Awesome. Thank you, guys. Good game.
Yes.
Thanks, Jenny.
That was fun. We'll play more games. If y'all like the games, let us know.
That was exciting.
We'll play more games. That was fun.
So did we tie?
Yeah, we'll call that a tie.
Okay. I like it.
You won. I can admit when you did great. That was great.
All right, now for some, you got some stuff to add on week's episode, right?
Henry Chambers is a dear friend of mine. I should have called Henry. Why didn't I call Henry? I wasn't thinking. Henry, he's a member at Macedonia, and he provided some good information. Let me pull that up real quick
about Tate City
that I didn't include. Listen, here's what he writes. Tate City was the industrial center of Towns County around 1900. The mining, did you know they did mining as well?
I had no idea.
They had large businesses, logging rapidly expanded into the area. A railroad was constructed from Tallulah Falls to the area of the old Girl Scout camp,
okay.
And I have seen that up there. Water Sprout Branch was so named as the steam engines filled up with water there. A train is underwater in the lake up there.
In the lake? I didn't know there was a lake at Tate City. You didn't even tell me
Lake
there was a lake.
I know. I blew it. Just below the Burton Dam, where it ran off of the track before the lake was built.
Oh, wow.
The only man hung in Towns County is buried on Flat Creek, which is Charlie's Creek in Hightower Road.
Oh, wow.
So how about that?
Yeah.
So now we need to go look for the abandoned train.
Yeah. I wonder if there's gold in it.
Oh, sounds like a Goonies.
That sounds like the story of the PB&J movie. Soon to be featured.
Coming to Pureflix this fall.
Speaking of things that are happening soon in the future. Most of you noticed this week that our very own Austin Watson has been engaged.
Yes. Congratulations,
Austin.
That's awesome.
Hey, if you don't know Austin Watson, he is a blessing and has done so much. He's so young, but he's done so much for so many churches in our area.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just to be, he was a part of our youth group.
Yep. But,
he did so much at Towns County High School, and now he leads worship and does some media stuff for Vertical Church in Blairsville. Just an amazing young man. And, man, Austin, thank you for everything you do, and thank you for really the testimony of your relationship right now. So,
I admire that.
I was actually the judge for Austin Watson's senior project.
Oh.
And back then it was, he helped with a D-Now. He kind of helped Ken Edwards. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Ken Edwards.
Oh, the
love
goat.
That man.
The goat.
And he basically took care of the musical aspect mm-hmm. that year of D-Now. And so that was, I got to grade his project.
Oh, wow.
Austin, congratulations. Mm-hmm. His fiance, what's her name?
Adelaide.
Yeah. I think that's right.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah, for sure.
I could remember.
Adelaide or Adelaide?
Yeah.
Adelaide.
Congratulations.
For sure.
Definitely.
Got yourself so, a good man.
Definitely.
Yeah.
AW.
Let's talk about love, marriage,
yeah.
dating,
so
all that.
So that
stuff.
Should be the direction of the show today.
How long have you been
for episode
married?
Episode 4. I've been married in May 8 years. So how many years have you been married?
So this May was 8 years or
this
next
May was May? 8 years, yes.
This March was 8 years for us.
So between us, we are love experts at 16
years
of combined marriage, not to each other,
so,
but to our significant other, beautiful so, wives.
Yeah, yeah. We have amazing wives that are amazing mothers.
Yes.
They really make us who we are for sure. So how long did you guys date? I want to ask you
okay,
that question.
Fun question. I get that a lot, and when I tell my youth, we talk about, you know, they've asked me this before. We dated 2 years. Mm-hmm. On our second anniversary, we got married.
You got married?
Married on day
oh, wow.
number, or whatever day, two years that day, May the 20th, 2020.
Wow.
2012. May the 20th, 2012. We dated May 20th, 2010 to May 20th, 2012.
Okay, nice.
Yeah. The Mayan calendar said it was all going to be over,
oh,
so
yeah.
I thought,
well,
what the...
Get hitched.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
No, but... So 2 years, and here's another fun fact. Do you know how old Ashley was?
No.
19.
Oh, wow. Okay. How old was
Kyle? How old were y'all? How long did y'all date, and how old were you? Y'all
okay.
dated less, didn't you?
We dated yeah. a lot less, yeah. So Kayla and I dated for 3 months, and I proposed... And
nice.
Then we were only engaged for 6 months. So 9 months after we essentially started dating, we were already married.
It was a love baby.
Oh,
just
yeah.
9 months
oh, yeah.
Of,
yeah,
of
9 months
dating
of
bliss. Yeah.
Yeah. So,
awesome.
So we got married March 10th, 2012. So
it's my birthday.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
His
that's right.
anniversary is my birthday.
Yep. So he always,
it's Chuck Norris's birthday, too.
Yeah. And he always texts me and says, happy anniversary.
I'll never forget his anniversary.
Because it's his birthday. And I'll never forget his birthday because he texts me and wished me happy anniversary.
Yeah, so it's great. So, it's good.
Yeah.
That
but
was...
I love being married. I love dating.
It's great.
I love the whole... You know, the way that God has designed marriage
yes.
and for us to find a helpmate and all that
mm-hmm.
cool stuff. And it's really, I'll say this to everybody watching, whether you are thinking about getting married, been married or whatever, that God's design for things
mm-hmm.
is just as true for marriage as it is for every other aspect. And
yeah,
so
that's
a good
word.
I think a lot of times people trust the Bible and they mm-hmm. trust God's words on everything else.
Mm-hmm.
But then we try to make our own way when it comes to love, sex, dating, and marriage
sure.
and all that thing. And God's design is perfect.
Yeah.
We followed God's law and God's design for, mm-hmm. for our dating relationship and for marriage. And God's blessing that. So,
yeah.
man, I just encourage
awesome.
Everybody else that's doing that as well.
I have 3 kids. We had Father's Day just the other day.
Yeah.
And I have 3 kids. You have 2.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Yep.
Yeah. And is that the end of
that's the
last Mohican?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Last...
My friend Pastor Bradley has 3 kids, and it made me realize that I only want 2.
It was a blessing in your life to see
yeah, yeah.
the
I saw
the
you do it,
struggle.
And I was like, nope, we're done.
Well,
I got
good.
2 beautiful boys. Love my boys for sure.
Let's talk, because I've done this, you've done this. This is part of my counseling when I counsel couples, the love languages.
Okay.
What is your love language? Well, let's first explain. So there's, help me with them. There's
Words of affirmation,
words of affirmation,
physical touch,
yeah.
gifts, acts of service.
Quality time.
And quality time.
So to put that in perspective.
What do you think my love languages are?
I thought it was gift cards.
Gift cards, yeah. Cash.
Cash
is my love language.
No, we've had this discussion. I want to say physical touch is one of yours.
Yep.
And are you bilingual? Do you have another love language?
I do.
Probably words of affirmation.
Mm-mm.
No? What is it?
Gifts.
Yeah, so it literally is
yeah,
gift cards.
It is
yeah,
gifts.
So that's how you perceive love
mm-hmm.
from Kayla. You
yep.
want her to be affectionate, and mm-hmm. you want her to give you gifts, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
All right. Now, what would her love languages? How does she receive love from you?
Hers is physical touch,
and it's also quality time.
Nice. Nice. So, yeah. Okay, so for me, I'm physical touch and words of affirmation. I love when she, you know, encourages me and tells me, you know,
you're the man.
Yeah, I like that.
Oh, yeah.
That's just how I, and she is very much a acts of service and quality time. Yeah. She loves just for us to have some time together. Quality time's hard to find with three kids, but we make time. The kids often will just, at the end of the day, we'll watch something together, and the kids will say, are y'all on a date? And we'll be like, yes, we are. Go to bed. So,
yeah.
So that, nice. You know, you have to carve out time and make time.
And you got to figure out how to fill your spouse's love tank. That's all, that's all part of the whole love languages thing, is figuring out how to fill their love tank. Yeah.
Because you can't run on empty.
No, not at all.
You cannot run on empty.
Not at all.
What about your best date or your worst date? Share one of those stories. Best or worst?
Best or worst.
Yeah. And I'll take whatever you don't take.
So, I don't know about a worst date. Maybe
there's... Do the best date.
Maybe there's one that I can't tell on camera. But hey, so there is this one thing that happened when Kayla and I were dating. Right after we got married. I hate mustard. Everybody knows that about me. I hate mustard. We went to the Macaroni Grill, and we ordered this sausage appetizer. It was like Italian sausages. Mm. Came out. I was so excited.
Yep.
And it had this paste to dip them in. And it looked like barbecue sauce kind of. And so Kayla tasted it, and she's like, that's mustard. Don't touch it. It's mustard. And I was like, man, I just want to... I want to be adventurous. Like, that doesn't look like mustard. I can't smell mustard. I want to try that. Because I think I might like it, and I don't want to miss out on it. So I took it and dipped it and put it in my mouth, and as soon as I did, I realized it was mustard.
Ooh.
And it was disgusting. So I looked. We hadn't got a napkin. all I had was a drink, and I didn't want to wash it down. So I literally, there was a plate with the bowl of the sauce on it. I picked up the bowl, and I spit it out.
Wow.
And put the bowl back on top of it.
Wow.
And she stayed married to me.
And that is your best date. So
that's
wow.
my best date.
That is his best date,
was,
people.
that's
a good story.
Yeah.
I like good stories. So, okay, here's a fun, this is a trip story, and I love telling this. I've told all kinds of people this story. Have I ever told you my Alabama story?
No.
Okay. Sit right back, kids, because it's about to be an adventure. So we went, it was our 1 year anniversary, and I said, honey, pack your bag. I'm taking you on a trip. It's going to be a surprise. Oh, and she was getting so excited. And I looked on a map. I just opened Google Maps, and I just said, okay, I had this idea we could go to different states, you know, and so our first anniversary, we'd go to Alabama. Now, nothing against Alabama. It's a wonderful place, Roll Tide and all that. Steve's watching, Steve Autry, Roll Tide, I guess.
Only good thing to come out of.
Only good thing. So there's a little town, and I saw this lake, and it was Lake Weiss, and I thought, ooh, that sounds nice. And I looked at pictures, oh, that's, you know, lovely. And so we went there, and on the pictures, it showed this, like, resort. And it had like a lighthouse. And I thought, man, the way they had photographed it, it looked like a beautiful lighthouse. We roll up, center Alabama is where this was. And the lighthouse comes up to right here.
Oh, wow.
I mean, it was tiny. It was the resort was attached to a restaurant. You had to go into the restaurant to get your key. They were all hanging on the wall. And there was a little man in the corner. It was karaoke night. He was singing, I'll be so blue in blue Hawaii. I mean, I can't make this up. This has to be a true story.
Yeah,
I can't make this up.
Yeah.
So she gives me my key. The room, it was the lake view, and it was like a rickety, the deck. I was afraid it was going to fall off into the kudzu. And so we get up to the top, and it was like, okay. So we switched rooms. We stayed one night. I said, okay, we can salvage this. Let's drive up the road and find a nice place to eat. So we pull into McDonald's, not to eat, but to ask. So I get out and I walk up and I said, hey, where's the nicest place to eat in town? And the guy turns to the whole kitchen and everybody else and says, hey, everybody, he wants to know the nicest place to eat in Center Alabama. The whole place died laughing. There was a Boy Scout troop in the back. All the Boy Scouts were laughing. There was an old married couple up here, and everybody laughed at us. But it turned out to be a good trip. But it was a rough start.
So did you go somewhere else from there?
So we stayed night one. There's a huge sign that said no refunds, but they did give us our night two back. And so we went.
Okay.
We did go up the road. We went to that unclaimed baggage store in Alabama. all the airports, they send their unclaimed baggage there. And, oh, wow. And so if it, you know, if they lose your bag and you don't claim it within however many days, they just buy in mass these trailers full of luggage and so iPads.
Did they go through all the stuff, or you just yeah, like they go buy
through,
a bag?
No, they go through the stuff, and it's like a store, but it's all unclaimed. That'd be a good field trip.
Yeah, I like that.
Unclaimed baggage in Alabama. So, so that's my story.
All right, so talking about our marriages and our kids and all that, and we just celebrated Father's Day. Give me some good dad jokes as we close out.
We got to have some dad jokes. So
I got one first.
You go first.
Since we've got since we've got the Funko Pops out here, everybody knows I'm a huge Batman fan. So, what do you call it when Batman skips church?
What do you call it?
Christian Bale.
I love it. I love it. While I'm pulling my joke up, which
Batman's
your
favorite? You're pulling your joke up? You're dad, dude. You got three kids.
No, I want to be sure I get it right. I don't want to mess this up. All right, so tell us while we're doing that your favorite Batman, because you're a huge Batman fan. Who is your favorite Batman?
Oh, Christian Bale by far.
Is it?
Yeah, he did an excellent job.
I am more of a Keaton.
Keaton was all right.
And he's supposed to be coming back.
I really like the Tim Burton Batmans. Mm-hmm. When Tim Burton did it, they're real dark and spooky and all that stuff. Yeah. I like that. But I think Christian Bale really, it's hard to embody Bruce Wayne and Batman
in the same character. He did well.
He did really, really good. I liked all that. Now, Ben Affleck, I wasn't disappointed with Ben Affleck.
He did a good job.
He did a really good job. Now, I've heard the guy that plays that's in those vampire movies, Twilight movies?
Yeah, Pattinson. Robert Pattinson is going to be the next one. He's a good actor. I know he's got a lot of...
I could see him definitely playing young Bruce Wayne.
Yeah.
So if this is kind of like an origin, if it shows young Bruce Wayne and young Batman, I really think he can pull that off.
Yeah.
But I'll be honest with you, Batman movies are so few and far in between that I'll take anything.
Yeah.
So
that's good. Part of the DC. You know, I'm more of a Marvel guy myself.
Yeah, for sure.
You like DC. That's fine.
Yeah, most sellouts are.
All right. I remembered my joke now. So why is the Bible so thick?
I don't know.
It's a long story. That's bad.
Oh, that's
all right. So
hilarious.
That's terrible.
Hey, that's been episode four. Hey, make sure you share our video. Make sure you introduce people to it. Thank you for Towns County FCA.
Thank you, Towns County FCA,
our sponsor.
Love
today.
It.
But yeah, make sure you share this, get it out there so people can see it. Check out our podcast. You can just look for our logo as you search for PB&J Show. Don't watch any other PB&J show. But our PB&J show.
Yeah, there's others out there, often imitated, never duplicated.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
For sure.
I like that. Hey, so y'all have a great day. We love you.
We love you.
Bye.